This interactive quiz was created in PowerPoint, and if you stay with me for the next 4 minutes, I'll show you two methods to create engaging PowerPoint quizzes just like this one. First, start by laying out the slides for all your questions. One slide per question. Place the question and answers on the left side of the slide and the feedback on the right side. You can make the quiz interactive using hyperlinks. To do this, duplicate question 1 three times. First, show the question on slide 2, then the correct and incorrect answers on slide 3, 4, and 5 respectively. To link the answers to the correct slide, select the rectangle for option A. Go to Insert tab, Link, and click Insert Link. Choose Place in this document. Select slide 3 and click OK. Repeat this process by linking option B to slide 4 and option C to slide 5. On the duplicate slides, link each option back to their corresponding slides. So, the quiz starts with the first question. Clicking on option A takes you to the slide with the correct answer. Option B takes you to the incorrect slide, and option C does the same. If this sounds like a lot for just one question, you are right. That's why I recommend iSpring Suite Max. It comes with Quizmaster for creating interactive quizzes in PowerPoint. Its customizable templates with live feedback are really a time saver. First, download and install the add-on. Once the installation is complete, open PowerPoint. Go to iSpring Suite 11 tab and click on Quiz. It will prompt you to sign in if it is your first time. After signing in, click on Quiz again and select Graded Quiz. Tap on Question and you will see a variety of question type templates to choose from. Let's go with multiple choice. Here you can enter your question. You can also use an image, a video, or an audio. Beneath the question are answer choices, where you can add your answers, and when you are done, select the option with the correct answer. Under feedback and branching, you can decide what happens when the user selects an answer. For example, when a correct answer is selected, it can allow the user to proceed to the next slide or end the quiz. The same settings apply for wrong answers as well. You can use slide view to see how the quiz will look on your slides. And when you are done, click Save and Return to Course, then on Preview to see the final result. Here is our interactive quiz with live feedback and scores. It can adjust to any screen size, making it easy and accessible to participants using different devices. And finally, let's publish the quiz. You can choose to publish it as HTML5 or as a video. HTML5 means the quiz will run on a web browser on your computer. This is handy if you want the quiz to be accessible on a website over the internet. When publishing is complete, click View Course to open the quiz in a web browser. iSpring also happens to be the sponsor of this video. By installing and trying the add-on, you are directly supporting me to share new and interesting ways to create amazing presentations in PowerPoint. Thank you in advance. Until the next video, keep creating amazing presentations.